Hello dear students, welcome back to the CLE Degree College Physics classes. Okay, in the last video already we discussed the nuclear fission on the basis of the liquid drop model as well as the shell model and their assumptions and the magic numbers. Okay, in today's class we will study the nuclear instruments. Okay, in nuclear instruments they are given, the first one is a Geiger-Müller counter, that we can call this as a GM counter, and the second one is a scintillation counter, and the third one is a linear accelerator, and the last four they given cyclotron. Okay, one by one we will see. So first we'll start the Geiger-Müller counter. First they given the diagram as well as the their construction. So first see here, the C is nothing but what? It is a metallic chamber containing air or a gas at a pressure of about 10 centimeter of a mercury. So Hg is nothing but a mercury. So see here, here they given the C. What is the C? It is a one metallic chamber, in that it containing air or a gas at a pressure. They given certain pressure. How much pressure? 10 centimeter of a mercury. Okay, so we completed this C. Next we'll move for the W. So they given W. What is the W? So see here, it is the fine tungsten wire. So see here, it is what? One fine tungsten wire stretched along the axis of the tube. So in this tube we are stretching this W, that is fine tungsten wire. So next here they given EE. So here EE is there. The EE is the end point of the tungsten wire, which is what? Made up of from adenoid. Okay, so EE is not a, it is the end point of the tungsten wire, which can be made of. So see here, this is a black dot EE, so which is made from what? Ebonite. Okay, next here R. The R is nothing but what? Resistance, which connect the tungsten wire. So see, the tungsten wire which can be connects with the resistance R to a positive terminal of a battery. So here the positive is there, that is positive terminal of a battery which connects the R, as well as the R connects the tungsten wire. Okay, here we completed the construction. So once again, C is a what? It is a metallic chamber which containing air or gas, and it has a certain pressure. How much? 10 centimeter of a mercury. Next W, it is a center wire which is made up of what? A fine tungsten. Okay, on the tube. Next EE, what is the EE? It is the end point of the tungsten wire, and which is made from ebonite. And the last one is R. R is what? It is connected to the W as well as the positive terminal of a battery. Okay, this is the construction. Next we'll move for the what? Working of a GM counter. So see here, in working, the first point wise they given. So they given 5 points. By that point we can see the working. How the GM counter counts the radiation of a particles. So see here, the first point, when an ionizing particle, we can take example any a particle. Okay. So see here, when an ionizing particle enters the counter, ionization takes place, and a few ions are produced. So here first what happened? So see here, this is our C first, metallic chamber which consists air of gas, in that the particle we are taking as a. By that particle ions are enter to this chamber. Okay, by entering the ions on this chamber, what happened? The ionization will be takes place. What is mean by ionization? Ionization is nothing but a collision or attraction between a positive and the negative ions. By the positive and negative, ionization will be takes place. So like that, the particle or the ions enter to the C, and here ionization are produced. So the few ions are produced here. Okay, so see the next point. Once the applied potential difference is strong, an avalanche of electron moves towards the center wire. Here we should have to concentrate on a avalanche. What is mean by avalanche, or the meaning of the avalanche? Avalanche is nothing but a sudden increase or increase of voltage or current. So how means here, we are applying the voltage through this C. In C, ions are there. If we applied the voltage or the potential, at that time avalanche of electron will taking place. Avalanche is means sudden increase of voltage of current. Voltage or current. So in that the strong potential will be takes place. So see it. Once the applied voltage, applied potential is a difference, is a strong. Means we are applying whatever the voltage or the potential is strong, that time avalanche of electron that will be moves what towards the center wire. And after that, that can be electron moves to the center wire, means W. Okay, next here, third. The critical potential is lowered. And after that, what happened? Whatever the critical potential is there, that will be lowered. Okay, because that are causing sudden discharge through R. So here, the critical potential is lowered is nothing but our discharge will be takes place through the resistance R. Okay, we'll move for the fourth point. Vacuum tube circuit amplifies the potential difference developed across the R, and a single particle can be registered. Next, what is the vacuum tube here? Here, so here, containing air or gas, means C is nothing but our vacuum tube. In a vacuum tube, the potential difference will be occur across the R, and that time one single particle can be registered. Registered means that particle radiation we can be count through the GM counter. Okay, here the GM counter is there. By that all ionization, we will get the reading of that particle. Okay, so next here, the sudden pulse of discharge sweep away. So here we are keeping one particle and counting their radiation. After completion of that particle's reading or the radiation, what to do means at that time the sudden pulse of discharge sweep away. That particle pulse is a discharge and a sweep away. And next what happened? The ions from the chamber and the counter is ready to register arrival of the next particle. So finishing of one particle means it will be take the next particle. Okay, so explain in this point. Okay, this is the water working of a GM counter. So here, in briefly, first ions are enter to the C. Okay, that is a metallic chamber. After that, ionization will be takes place. Next, we are applying the potential, strong potential. That time, the avalanche will be taking place and it will be moved towards the center wire. Next, after that, R through discharge will be takes place. And the next point, in next point, what happened? The first particle, what happened? It is registered, or the reading will be noted. After that, it can be allowed to the next particle. Okay, like that, by this we can count the radiation of that particle. Okay, this is the water working. Okay, after that working, we will get the water, the voltage characteristics of a GM counter by plotting the graph. So we should have to plot the graph. The x-axis is versus voltage and the y is count per minute. So see here, in graph, first can call this as a threshold voltage. Next what happened? Increasing. Okay, after increasing, plateau. Plateau region is nothing but a constant region. Whatever the reading we got here, that all are constant. Next again, increases. So first point we'll see here. So see here, in a first, the zero count rate at the threshold voltage means GM tube does not work. So at the threshold voltage, our GM tube does not work, means it is in a rest position. We are not allowing to work this GM tube. Okay, so this is the first point, means our threshold voltage is at a zero. Next here, as the applied voltage increases, after that we are applying the voltage, and voltage increases means avalanche will be takes place. So that times here, as the applied voltage increases, count rate reaches plateau. So next here, we are applying the voltage means it will be increases, after that it reaches to the plateau region, where counting rate is independent of applied potential difference. Here whatever the counting rate is there, that is independent by the applied voltage or the potential. ओके नेक्स्ट ईयर कंटिन्यूअस डिस्चार्ज टेक्स प्लेस आफ्टर दैट व्हाट हैपन द डिस्चार्जिंग ऑफ दिस विल टेक्स सो द कंटिन्यूअस डिस्चार्ज टेक्स प्लेस इन द जीएम ट्यूब व्हेन द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज इज फर्दर इनक्रीज्ड बाय इनक्रीजिंग द फर्दर वोल्टेज दैट डिस्चार्जिंग विल टेक्स प्लेस बट दैट डिस्चार्जिंग वी आर वॉन्ट अवॉइडिंग इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट सो वी कैन राइट दिस रीजन मस्ट बी अवॉइडेड फॉर द एक्सपेरिमेंट ओके सो दिस 3 point we completed. Next year, efficiency they given. The definition of the efficiency. So the efficiency of the counter, which counter we are using? GM counter. Okay. So the efficiency of the counter is defined as ratio of observed count per second. Okay. What we are observing in this counter? Whatever the radiation is there, that radiation we are counting. So it is the ratio of observed count per second to the what number of ionizing particle entering the counter per second. Whatever the ionizing particle entering to the counter, that with respect to counting rate per second. Okay, this we can call the efficiency of the counter. Okay, next they give one counting efficiency. So counting efficiency is defined as it is nothing but ability of its counting. Okay, ability of counting we can call this as a counting efficiency. And the last they given the counting efficiency that counting efficiency is equal to 1 minus e raised to SLP. Okay, where S is nothing but what a specific ionization at 1 atmospheric pressure. Okay, S is what it is the what a specific ionization at 1 atomic pressure. L is nothing but a here L is a path length of the ionization particle in the counter and a P is nothing but a pressure in a atmosphere. Okay, this is nothing but what a voltage characteristics of the GM counter. Okay, in today's video we completed the GM counter in that a construction as well as the working and the voltage characteristics of the GM counter. Okay, in the next video we will start the scintillation counter again its construction, working, etc. Okay, hope all of you understood. We'll continue in next video. Thank you.